Welcome everybody, it's that time. It's been a few weeks, like a month maybe, since the last time I've had to do a recording, but we are at Los Angeles. I've driven down from San Jose, it's like a 5-hour drive, and I'm at the convention center, and this is Grand Prix LA. The format's going to be modern, and I've been testing modern for basically since I came back from the Pro Tour, because this was really the only tournament that I was testing for. So I'm on my way. This is the LA Convention Center. At least inside. It's kind of empty today. Yo, what's up? It's kind of empty today. You know, it's Friday. And this convention center is absolutely huge.
There's Mashi and President CEO of Channel Fireball, John Sasso. How you guys doing?
Channel Fireball President.
I always mess it up.
Channel Fireball President and CEO.
I don't know about that shirt, though.
This is a Dodgers shirt, but guess what? We're in Los Angeles now.
Get that trash out of here.
This is the only time I can wear
it.
I can't wear it in San Jose. So yeah. I mean, I have to get, is the president CEO of Channel Fireball? I have to get him on here. I mean, he's the one who writes the checks. So.
Wow.
So I've never actually made it in time. I've actually never been to one of these magic seminars, just because I'm never at the site when they actually do the seminars. So we have today Ben Stark and Tom Martell doing the modern preview seminar here. So we'll quickly turn it over.
It's a separate list sweeper, so there's a lot of shatter storms. You're gonna be kind of
talking about affinity here.
Next up here is the newest variant on Zoo, Death Shadow Zoo. So Zoo is kind of a blanket umbrella deck description for decks that typically rely on Wild the Coddle. But lots of small sheep creatures that are putting pressure on your life total. Also related to this is going to be decks like Naya Burn, playing cards like Goblin Guide, but this is sort of the newest variation here. Its signature card is Death Shadow, which those who are not familiar with it, it's a 1-mana, the 13-13, which is pretty big for 1-mana, it costs 1 black, but it gets -X, -X, where the X is your life total. So once you're down to 12, you get a 1-1. Once you're down to 1, you have a 12-12. So it plays lots of ways that deal damage to itself. For people who played a Tarka Red in Standard, you're going to recognize the Teemer Battle Rage Complements combo, which is, this is the best shell for that modern. It's putting a lot of cards into your graveyard, cards like Attacks and Probe, cards like
Attention players
bottle,
in the 430 Vintage
very powerful explosive deck, but does a lot
your
of damage to itself.
Are going up
this deck is
on the banner
right
near the giant
it doesn't line up well with some
near the red
and so that's a burn
once again,
that punishes decks, but now this deck pretty much has free reign to try and combo out slower decks, decks that are trying to play a bunch of spells that cost 3-4 mana, and all your cards are so cheap, and as soon as they tap out for one of those spells, like Nahiri, you just kill them.
It does not line up well against Burn, though, if you take 7 life or 8 life, and then they have a playable. So Burn's a bad matchup, but this deck I think is a real position for this weekend, very powerful, kind of raw power deck.
I'm just taking
legs. We have a crab cocktail, oysters all around. I did the shrimps, one each. It's funny sausage, gentlemen.
Horseradish.
Horseradish. Just be careful with that. It's spicy and not on your palate, in your nose.
In your nose. Nice.
You know how it is. I love it. Cocktail sauce. We have mustard mayo. The same thing. We have.
This is the famous seafood tower at Mastro's. I'm hanging out with my old roommates here. We've got Ronnie, Rick, and my best man. We've got Alex Lee here. He actually flew in like an hour ago and straight to the steakhouse. So we're eating it.
Put the champagne.
Oh, we got the champagne up in here as well. And time for the main course at Mastro Steakhouse. Bam, we got some lobster mac, mashed potatoes. Lobster mashed potatoes, some cream corn, mushrooms, and a 22-ounce bone-in ribeye. This is gigantic, right?
Ronnie got the 33-ounce.
Yeah, like,
bone, the 32-ounce. Like, this is big, like, yeah. I mean, this is bigger than Ronnie's head.
I can't take a good, this is our butter cake. This is for one order of dessert, but it's for all of us. And this is, they give us 1 million pounds of whipped cream.
There you go.
Oh, there you go. Oh, look at that. It's like a heavenly,
heavenly
thing of deliciousness. Oh my God. And the whipped cream. Oh yeah. Let's dig in, boys. So I am here, day one of Grand Prix Los Angeles. It's right. Still round two. I still have to wait one more round before I get to play my matches. Feeling good, well rested, and I've been testing, you know, for the last 3 or 4 weeks, pretty extensively. So I just want to make sure that everything's good, mindset's right, and I just gotta go 3-3 to make day two. I mean, the biggest goal here is just to pick up that one extra pro point. Obviously, I want to win all my matches, but that one pro point is super important, because if I do pick up that one pro point, it will give me 30 points on the season, meaning if I just show up to Pro Tour Sydney, I'll have 33 and lock up gold for next year, which is really important. And if I do that, I probably won't be traveling to any other Grand Prix. The only thing that might make me go to more Grand Prix is if I like top 8 or win this one, because I have a lot of extra finishes available. But for now, I'm not really looking to do anything else past this if I get my one. Here at the coverage area, we have the tag team here of Huey and Marshall. And over there, we have Luis and Gabby Sparks. Earlier, Marshall got me on his Marshall log. Apparently that's what it's called. But I don't know, I think they're just kind of hanging out. Yeah, do you see this camera compared to yours? This is just a little hand cam, you know. Hey, look, I can get like 10 of mine for one of yours probably. Wow, look at that. So yeah, that's dude, it's good. This was recommended. This a big time vlogger uses this camera. That's why Lisa told me to buy it.
Like 2002.
2002? When I was a high school student. Yeah, that is Marshall's camera. And mine is a little, yeah. Mine is about,
set this here for you.
Yeah, just to put things in perspective, I mean, this is a Goliath. When'd you get this camera?
I've had this for a long time.
Yeah, but that's a nice camera.
Yeah,
yeah.
But I've been doing photography for a long time. So
yeah.
It just happens to do videos so I can.
Okay, yeah, well that's pretty lucky.
That's pretty lucky.
It's okay. The chalog's better anyways. Well, off to a rough start. Always feels, you know, that first loss always just takes the wind out of your sails, and this is my first loss. It was also my first round, and I lost to the Goblin Bushwhacker that we went to 3 games, and I'm not sure if I was supposed to keep this hand. I'm going to ask a bunch of people and probably dwell on it too much, but I mulliganed the hand into Sacred Foundry, Bolt, Celestial Purge, Snapcaster Mage, Serum Visions, Cryptic Command on the draw. So it was a 6-card hand with a Sacred Foundry and a Bolt with a Scry. And I have 19 blue sources in my deck, and I'm on the draw. So I get 3 looks at a land there. If I draw a land, I'm looking pretty good, because I can go Bolt into Purge. And then if I draw a blue source, I can Serum Visions to find more lands. So I thought it was better than going to a 5. Especially because I have the Bolt. And, unfortunately, did not find a land in the top 3 cards of my library. And wasn't able to stabilize. And so, it's been unfortunate. I think the Goblin deck is actually a pretty decent matchup. But, you know, there is obviously variance in the game. And we have our first loss. Long, long way to go. And hopefully we can win more matches afterwards. Oh, I also found out something else kind of crazy. Apparently, the other Grand Prix, something happened with the system, where now they're just pairing people at random. So a 3-0 can play against a 1-2, which is insane. You know, obviously this is just, you know, a decision that, you know, one of those split second decisions you have to make. It's like, well, either we're gonna cancel the tournament or we have to pair people at random. So I guess they went with pairing people at random, but then it leads to pretty like,
it's worth it to be a little slower.
You know, very, very unfair pairings where people who are just like 1-5 can play against somebody's 5-0 and just concede. So, it's a bit awkward. So I'm not sure how they're exactly going to go about solving that problem, but I do feel bad for all the people who's in charge and have to try to, you know, sort through all of that mess. But, only 4 rounds. There's 9 rounds today, so 5 more rounds to go. I'm going to win all of them. Off to a very rough start. I lost my first 2 rounds. Just lost to the Jeskai Mirror. And I should have seen it coming, but no. I lost game 3 to Geist of St. Traft on turn 3, and I did not have the counter spell. He just jammed it, and people are gonna have stuff for the mirror, and That's obviously one very effective card. I didn't see game two. If I saw it, I might have considered bringing in an anger or two, or even a timing reinforcements. But yeah, I mean, the guys just went all the way. Your deck's just playing a bunch of spot removal, so it's really hard to deal with. And I drew my Snapcaster Mages and clicks, but, you know, he's got his fair share of removal as well, so it ended up getting me pretty good. And he played pretty well as well. So, 3-2 for now. Gotta win a lot of matches. It's a really, really disappointing start. Well, I am 0-3. 0-3 on the day. Lost with another mirror. Actually, Nathan Calvin, kid from the Los Angeles area. Pretty solid Magic player. I don't think he plays as much anymore since he went to college, which is the correct thing to do. And yeah, we played the Jeskai mirror, and I believe I made a mistake in the second game, which probably cost me the match. So obviously not feeling great. Haven't really tested too much actually against the mirror, because I was pretty much like one of the few people who actually played with that. There's a Marshall behind me with his gigantic camera in his martial arts. And so yeah, I got to win 3 in a row. I really obviously need this pro point, and I'm really hoping I can get there. You know, I'm trying my best to shake it off, but it kind of sucks. You know, you spend all this time. I spent like 3 weeks preparing for this event, and just losing your first 3 rounds in a row, and losing 2 to the deck that you really helped tune a lot, and so that's really unfortunate. But at least the deck's winning. Just it's not me doing the winning. So yeah, 3 more rounds to go. Let's take it 1 match at a time. Actually, we have a few other brews here. Let me put my drink down. We have Matt Nath on a sweet little brew. What are you playing?
Green, white tokens.
So Nissa and Gideon, right?
Yep.
So you're just playing face-to-faces green-white tokens deck with more ramp creatures. Is that basically what you're doing?
Spectre Possession, Lingering Souls, Raise the Alarm.
Raise the Alarm?
I mean, that's what you get.
Questionable card. Has it been great?
It's been pretty good, yeah.
Actually, so, he literally said 5 minutes ago, voluntarily, Raise the Alarm's been great.
Why did you decide to play this deck?
I thought there would be a lot of Lightning Bolt decks, like Blue Red, Grixis.
And this deck is very good against those decks?
Yeah, like Planeswalkers, it can't be bolted, it's like Gideon.
Right.
Like, they have to use their spot removal, like a Raise the Alarm token or a Spectral token.
Bolting a Soldier token feels really bad.
Oh yeah, my opponent did it many times last
year. Yeah, yeah. Have you been playing only mid-range decks so far?
Burn and Infect, which are... Infect's not that bad because you have so many flyers. You just like kill their Blight Mage and block everything.
If they have flip through space, it's annoying. But a lot of decks are not playing that. Or Blighted Agent with protection.
Yeah.
But,
You have 4 path, 2 dismember, and then Gutshot, post forward. You have a lot of removal.
Okay, so that's one matchup you were kind of ready for.
Not that bad. Yeah.
Sure.
Compared to other unfair decks. And then Burn, you have like Burnt and Fortune, and Timely.
So you're weak against like Tron or something, right? Probably. Yeah. Hey, how's it going? Okay. This is the second time that's happened to me today.
So
I was standing right next to it. And
how'd you do it? Did you kick it out of your own hand?
No, but he didn't even say anything. He didn't even apologize or anything.
I think he only did that because he was on camera.
I guess. I don't know. I mean, like, he's not even like helping clean. I mean, that's a little rude. But yeah. Anyways, 6-0. Best of luck. Well, I did not win a match today. Sucks. I mean, obviously a lot of people also put in a lot of time and effort into, you know, preparing for these tournaments, but, you know, I didn't play like a month, and this was the only tournament that I tested for, and I put in a lot of efforts, and, you know, failing to win a match. This is the first time I've ever 0-4 to Grand Prix, and I dropped. Just frustrating, yeah. need one pro point, and now I have to figure out another Grand Prix to go to, which just puts a lot more strain on, you know, Lisa, in terms of like watching the kids for the weekend with our newborn. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I don't know if I should just not go to any Grand Prix and just try to get 4 points at the last Pro Tour, or if I should go to a Grand Prix. I don't know. I really thought I had a good chance at this tournament. Modern is a format that I test a lot. I have a good amount of success playing the format, but you know, obviously stuff like this happens. It's just getting 0-4. Like, I didn't even get to get any momentum going. I just lost every single match. So, you know, what am I going to do for the rest of the trip? I have no idea. I don't know if I'm going to come back to the site tomorrow, but maybe I can find some friends to hang out with, or spend more time with my family as well. Yeah, 3-4 drop, Grand Prix, Los Angeles.
You want to film this vlog?
Yeah, so we're at the NHTSA banner here. We have Dr. Chris Baker, chiropractor, and you are working on people's back for the Pro Tour, and I just signed up, so I'm gonna get some good game massage. Did you just get this made?
Yep.
Pretty sweet,
sir. Fresh. I just got the art commission this week, so.
Are you gonna do this for multiple Grand Prix?
The goal is to get
Channel Fireball Grand Prix.
All Channel Fireball, and then beyond. Every GP deserves massage therapy.
So well, I mean, yeah, like you have Mashi and John, both are pretty old guys, so like they need some of that treatment. So I understand why this is here.
They take care of everybody. And their staff and their events. They want to see a high quality service, you know, get disseminated for the people. So,
okay, cool. Sounds good. Oh, yeah, it's time.
Yeah, we got some movement. Something cracking.
Whatever.
Wince in like a
yeah. This is pain.
Poor old man Chion.
So I just finished getting my massage / treatment, and I feel more tired. I feel tired. All the muscles here have relaxed a little more, so it definitely feels great.
Good game massage. You guys should definitely check it out whenever there's like, especially a Channel Fireball Grand Prix. You know, hopefully we can get more of these, because getting the treatment is a great feeling. Thanks, Chris. Yeah.
We have Channel Fireball. We have a judge's back. And we have
Channel Fireball local Paulo Qua playing for 9-0 at this Grand Prix, battling against an Affinity player who's up a game.
Hi Sean.
Not even hi mom.
No. Sean is the only one who's gonna watch that.
Wesley, that's who he's playing against. Paulo is down a game here. It's Abzan Company against Affinity, but table one. That's pretty exciting. One. That's the number of matches I would have at least liked to have won today, but it did not happen. Did not win one match. We are wandering the mean streets of Los Angeles here, hanging out with the coverage team. Gabby Sparks, Marcy Sutcliffe, Luis, and friends and spouses. Yeah, you're in the schlag. Yeah, you got a good photo bomb in the last one.
I know,
the Pro Tour. That I don't know what face that was. But
I feel like viewers are getting a kind of warped view of me in the schlag, because you all seem to catch me right at the moment when I'm doing some things. You know, that could be interpreted as not nice to
No. I think they're getting a taste of the real Luis. At least my version.
Uncensored, right?
Because
uncensored,
I know he acts.
I'm the censor, I never swear.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Why are you laughing?
Yeah, exactly. Never ever swear, never says anything bad. And yeah. I mean, you know, I feel like.
Okay, look how good of a friend I am. When I found out you went 0-4, I was gonna tell you that we did a factor fiction, Will Paul Make Day 2.
Somebody told me this already!
And I voted fiction, but I instead didn't tell you that because
I wanted to be in the fifth.
Yeah. Oh.
You know what? You're in the martial arts.
Oh wow, God, I'm in the martial arts. Look at this! Look at this!
No, don't point them at each other. Anything can happen.
Now you're on the LS. I'm like less.
Oh, the LS vlog? This is unreal! This is just becoming the thing. This is becoming the thing. Yes.
So we're eating at a very nearby Mexican restaurant that got 2.5 stars on Yelp. And, you know, I chose not to go here, but then we realized that the road was closed and we had to turn around and cross the street. And that would take us at least one extra minute of inconvenience.
Our will was weak, that tipped the scales.
Yeah, it was literally, please turn around, go down half a block. And we were just like, no, that's not an option. So now we're gonna take our chances with this restaurant.
So Gabby ordering a margarita, and it is a flaming margarita.
Yeah, this is like some next level.
What's burning? Is that like a lemon rind?
I think it's like a lemon wedge.
Lemon wedge or something, but that does look pretty cool.
I don't know, it's very cool.
Yeah.
I actually didn't order this, so.
You ordered a margarita.
Yeah, I didn't think it was gonna be flaming.
Well, no, it says on the menu.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
All right.
You should probably blow it out now. Happy birthday. Of course, the usual credit card game. BK's first person safe. First person safe. Oh my god. Yeah, because I have excellent timing. It's like I've done this before. Four is safe. You're gonna do not throw it at me. You threw it out of my chimichanga, dude. That's so gross. You're unreal, dude. You're very close. You're very close. I hope I don't pick your card, number 3. Oh God. That would have been... Really? Really?
The best part about this game is that Gabby's like convinced the fact that her and Emerson have 2 cards in, but their odds have somehow gotten worse.
No justice. Oh, but he has Aberdasher's card. He has Aberdasher. Come on, Aberdasher! Come on! Yeah, I understand. I understand. We all understand. Are you away from Marshall Street?
Yeah, I'm just at 2:30 at night.
So. Oh, okay.
Sometimes.
The Spartans are safe! They are safe! Oh! It is Marshalog Blockcliff versus LS Blog in the finals of the credit card game. This hand?
That one is safe.
Oh, this hand is safe. Oh, no. Hey, you're recording it. You just saw it. Sad face. Oh no. Well, thank you, Marshall. Thank you very much. Yeah. So on my way to a modern event showdown, I guess, on Sunday. It's for all the people who did not make day 2 or who did not participate in the tournament. But it's 9:24. The tournament starts at 9:30, and I haven't registered and I don't have a deck. So let's see if we can get it done. So apparently Luis, you know, part of coverage, he has a Luis's keys to modern.
It's LSV's keys.
LSV's keys to modern, and we go up and he literally...
Unlocking modern for
the viewers. That is literally the keys for modern.
I don't actually like using this thing, but it's for the viewers.
Right. Brought this?
No, I didn't bring this.
Yeah.
I ordered it and I got it shipped here. No. I was worried about bringing it because it's too big to stick on the airplane.
It'd be like because you just carry on, right? It's like a weapon. Can you stop? You're unlocking the.
What is unlocking it? The keys to the format.
Yeah,
I
took apparently.
A picture with a key in my hand for context.
Yeah, yeah. I gotta get this first before it gets on the martial law block cliff. Do you really need to poke me with it?
Okay.
If coverage is
be professional.
Okay, yeah.
Be professional
as you're stabbing me with the key, with the giant metal key. Yeah, yeah.
It's actually pretty heavy. You probably heard about that kid pulling it.
Yeah. Okay. So dumb. And people wonder, you know, like you know that one Magic TV episode where me and Mashi and Luis was on, and you know we were just kind of giving him a hard time, and then people were saying, why are you bullying Luis?
Well, this is why. Just every now and then, we just have to, you know, we have to dish it out a little bit because, I mean, look at that thing.
This is not real.
It is pretty ridiculous. It's perfect, actually, but. In the feature match area here. Got some people still doing well in the tournament, you know, still alive. Pascal, what's your record, Pascal? Are you down a game or up a game? You won the match? That's a lot better. That's a lot better. What round is this?
Second to last round.
Second? Wait, are you locked?
No, I need to win this round.
Can you draw?
I assume I can draw.
Oh, okay. Well, good luck, man. It's good. Awesome. X Pascal at X2. There's Mashi doing Mashi things with his four sunglass Twitter ridiculous picture.
Don't get jealous. You hate me because you hate me.
Wow.
Everyone thinks you are.
Wow. Yeah, that's also true. Unfortunately.
Yeah.
Did you end up top 8ing?
Huh?
Did you end up top 8ing?
Yeah.
Sweet. What was that 10? Was that 10 top 8s?
Yeah.
Dear Lord, that is a lot of tape hits. Congratulations, man. Congratulations. What are you playing?
Banned Eldrazi.
Oh, banned. Okay. Whatever. We'll see. Well, I'll take a look in the coverage.
We'll see
but
what Luis says about.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, he might actually leave before the top 8, but that's cool. Oh, congratulations, man.
All right.
All right. So it looks like the top 8. I mean, those 6 rounds are pretty quick. So the top 8's been determined. I think. Pascal Maynard's in the top 8. Let me see. Is there anybody? Who else is in the top 8 here? Joe Lissette, maybe? And this is the top 8, I'm assuming? Oh, Corey. Yeah, let me, I guess I should congratulate my teammate. Pascal, I wish you luck earlier, but now I kind of hope you get mana screwed because you're playing with my teammate. Yeah, I know he's playing like the Bant deck. Is it bad for you? Don't you have a bunch of removal spells? Oh, I guess.
Yeah, but all of his guys are just like resilient.
It's okay, that's why I said he's gonna get mana screwed. Or something. Hopefully. Well, congratulations though. Good luck. Yeah, alright, so it looks like, yeah, the top 8's firing off. You know, we have Joe Lissette, Corey Burkhardt, and Pascal Maynard are the people that I know that top 8'd. And, Corey and Pascal are battling in the first round, so I imagine they're going to be the main feature. And yeah, best of luck. Like both of them a lot, so best of luck. May the best man win. Pro players, we got. I guess he's qualified for the Pro Tour. We got my good friend. Yeah, we're playing two-headed giant. Currently 3-0. It's a 4-round tournament. Just a random side event, but yeah. Wanted to have a little bit of fun, so I think we're probably just gonna play out that last round, do some dream crushing. Yeah. So yeah, Rick is a good friend of mine, and he actually top 8'd the Grand Prix Albuquerque, beating out Numat Nummi in the last round for the qualification. So you know, I said this before. You know, Kenji has a weakness; he cannot defeat old Asian men, as he hasn't beaten me, and you know, he's got. And he ended up losing to Rick as well. And here is an old Asian man. I may have not been able to win a match at the Grand Prix, but yeah, spoils of war. Grinding the side events. We went 3-0, and we actually, you know, part of me wanted to play the last round, but there was such a huge prize difference between 4-0 and 3-1 that we just split. I think, you know, we like, our decks were pretty good, but you know, it's kind of a feel bad when you refuse to split for like a casual event. So we decided to split it, played it out, and it was a pretty fun match. So this is it for Grand Prix LA. It's going to be a little bit shorter, mostly because it was not very eventful for me, because I was mostly just playing side events and having a good time. But it's still nice, you know, just to come down to LA. Got my family here and a lot of good friends. So I'm going to be having dinner, then driving up late at night back to San Jose, back to streaming, and back to taking care of the kids. So thank you all for watching. And I don't know who actually won the GP, but I'm really rooting for Corey Burkhardt and Pascal. So I really hope those, either of those guys end up winning the whole tournament. But until then, I'll see you guys at the next Grand Prix.
So we're here in the top four of the Grand Prix. And Ethan, your dad told me to say hi to you.
So
how's it going, man? How you doing?
Good.
Top four, you're crushing it. Crushing it with Affinity against Pascal. This guy has 10 Grand Prix top eights. You think you can take him down? I know, are you Ethan Brown on the stream?
Yeah.
And you're the ones like always just play Affinity, yeah. Right? And now you're in top four. So I should have listened to you because I didn't win a match yesterday.
Yeah.
Well, anyways, best of luck, man. All right? Congratulations, top four. You excited to qualify for the Pro Tour?
Yes!
All right, man. That's awesome. Yeah, that was a feel-good moment for the tournament. That's awesome just to see somebody, you know, who I see regularly on the stream and to have him have a lot of fun. And his dad actually came up to me and was like, hey, this guy really loves the stream. And, oh, man, I'm feeling all, like, tingly right now. I you know, want him to do well. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Maybe I'll have Kyle or Jake pull something off like that in the future. You know, when they get older and when daddy just becomes an old has-been talking about his accomplishments 20 years ago. But, yeah. Okay, that's it, I promise. Grand Prix LA 2016. And best of luck to you, Ethan. Best of luck to you, Ethan.